The COVID-19 pandemic's impact across the region depends on the severity of domestic lockdowns, says Fitch Ratings. The credit ratings agency expects flat telecom revenue this year in the Philippines, reeling from one of the world's longest lockdowns. With us now for more from Singapore is Janice Chong, director for Fitch Ratings. Good to see you again, Janice. Welcome to the program. Right, so how exactly is the severity of the domestic lockdown here impacting telco revenues when internet usage had moved to the home as offices remain closed or have been operating at half capacity because of the continuing quarantine restrictions?
Yeah, I think in the Philippines, we are seeing one of the more stringent lockdown restrictions for India. I think in terms of CAPEX, clearly we're seeing a delay 5% this year. A lot of this is due to the network construction being hampered by the limited mobility issues as well as shortages. So all in all, this is going to affect the kind of network capacity rollout this year.
Right, so you're saying that the surge in home internet use is not enough to offset the drop in consumer and enterprise spending?
Well, you know, one thing on the surge in data traffic, and on the other hand, is the ability to monetize these data services fully. I think there has been a challenge in the Philippines. Is a global challenge, in fact, by other telecom operators. I think the danger is when you run into risks when the restrictions have already been eased, but there is a prolonged relief measures continue to be extended by the telcos themselves.
All right, so what impact then will this have on the ARPU, or the average revenue per user, for this year alone?
I think in terms of average revenue per user, I mean, that's likely to be flat to decline, really depends on the economic recovery. So we're expecting a gradual recovery in the second year from a trough in the second quarter this year itself. So it really depends on how fast the mobile resurgence in EBITDA will take place. In our base case, we're expecting to be rather gradual this year.
The president is about to decide on what's to come of the current quarantine restrictions in Metro Manila. If the restrictions are loosened further, what impact do you think this will have on the predominantly large prepaid base here in the Philippines?
Well, you know, when restrictions have been eased, and generally that would be good for the economy, probably not so good in terms of, you know, how the government will be able to curb the pandemic situation. I think a lot of it really depends, as we said, on the restriction, how long will the lockdown continue. I think in terms of the economic recovery, that really plays a big role. In terms of leverage, we are seeing leverage increasing for both operators as CAPEX continue to increase over the next couple of years. And on top of that, we do see a lagging operating cash flows. So in the past, this has always been an issue of low return on investments. And with the pandemic, this is likely going to be a challenge.
Right. Prepaid base is really subject to greater cash flow volatility. So what conditions do we need to see consumer spend picking up again in the prepaid market?
I think a lot of that has got to do with, one obviously is consumer spending and getting the economy to resume to where it was again. And secondly, it's really on the basis of enterprise spending, and that is going to come back a little more delayed than consumer spending. I think on top of that, it's really, during the pre-COVID situation, we have already seen a good pickup in data consumption, and that continues to rise. In fact, both incumbent operators have done a fairly good job in driving revenue growth for mobile and fixed broadband. really, I think ultimately is whether how do you then turn some of this data traffic into revenues? That would be a challenge in terms of how would you then monetize that situation.
And it becomes more difficult when you think about the remittances, because on top of all this, you cite remittances as potentially slowing the recovery of the domestic telco markets. But how so?
Yes, well, Philippines being a remittance-based economy, that would naturally mean that there will be a slower recovery in terms of the economy. And like all sectors, telecom sector is in fact pegged to the economy in the sense that if a slower economy would drive a slower recovery in telecom, because ultimately it comes from consumer enterprise spending. But having said that, the telecom sector is still one of the most resilient sector due to the pandemic, because of the essential nature of its services that will likely outperform, enable the industry to outperform the GDP trend.
Right, which brings us to network resilience. I mean, given this backdrop, telcos are now forced to balance their manage their balance sheets through cost cutting. So what is this going to mean for the telco firm's CapEx on 5G?
Yeah, so CapEx for 5G, well, it really depends on the function of demand and supply. And from a demand's perspective, we are seeing that 5G demand, like most emerging markets, is unlikely to take place in the next 2 years. On top of that, telcos are likely to conserve cash and prioritize cash investments on more critical investments. So that is likely to delay 5G investments as well. And on top of that, if you look at the supply perspective, we're not seeing a lot of affordable 5G devices coming on stream, given the trade tension and the increasing security concerns with Huawei network equipment that will continue to delay 5G smartphones in the market.
Yeah, so what happens now then to the third telco player, Dito Telecommunity? I mean, it was just starting to get started on a 5G network build and construction when the pandemic hit.
Yeah, I think in terms of Dito, we are unlikely to see a commercial rollout earlier than the first half of 2021. So this is likely to delay competition, given the network construction delays that we're seeing from the incumbent network telcos themselves. One can imagine how difficult it would be for the new player to roll out its entire network from scratch this year.
So you're expecting leverage metrics to be stretched, but for how long now, as operational cash flows lag behind these investment outlays?
We are expecting leverage to creep up towards 2.8 times from the current 2.2 to 2.5 times over the next 18 months. So this is really a function of how fast can EBITDA recover, how fast can cash flow recover ahead of the kind of investments, CapEx investments, telcos are spending at the moment.
And you're seeing this continuation of the convergence of the leverage profiles of both Globe Telecom and PLDT. I mean, you've got a triple B minus stable for Globe and a triple B stable for PLDT.
That's right. PLDT is rated one notch higher than Globe, mainly due to the wider service diversification and robust mobile and fixed line position, which we say is advantageous, you know, in providing convergence, especially when Dito comes into the market next year. But having said that, PLDT's rating headroom remains very limited at this stage, given the aggressive CapEx investment going forward.
Just a final point, Janice, what would be the triggers for a revisit of the current ratings on Globe and PLDT?
Could you repeat that?
Yes, what would be the reasons, the triggers for you to revisit the current ratings for both Globe and PLDT?
Right. Yeah. All right. Yeah, I think that really depends on how long the restrictions continues, how long the kind of duration that it would take for the telcos to recover, for the economy to recover. And in a way, you know, CapEx investments, although we are expecting about 25% delay in CapEx this year, but it depends. I think it remains very uncertain on how much the ultimate capex would be like this year. And on top of that, telcos are also offering deferment in terms of installment payments for postpaid customer, enterprise customers over a stretch of 6 to 12 months. All these relief measures, how long would this continue? The fact that if it does continue to affect cash flows more severe than our expectations, then this would eventually prompt a revisit of the ratings.
All right. Thank you so much. One of the more resilient industry sectors post the pandemic, but still facing challenges. Appreciate the assessment there, Janice. You keep well. Janice Chong of Fitch Ratings in Singapore.